Hello everybody, what's going on? I'm your host Magnetic over at the Bomb Squad Official, and today we are going to be fighting the PyroDemon for the 43rd time. And I would have been able to do this sooner, but I was out and I couldn't really make a video while I was out. But so we're gonna go ahead and grab our best friends. So we are looking for people that have the Harlequin's Rogue Gear, which is the most recent Fire and Water Guild War Epic. So I'm just gonna look around here real quick. And I'm not seeing anyone yet. Looks like Master GLSAE has it, so we're gonna go ahead and use him in our roster. I'm looking for Clash OL 100. There he is. I knew he had a Harlequin Rogue Gear. I just had to find him. So shout out to Master GLSAE and Clash OL 100 for being my friends and helping me out in this boss battle. So yeah, so I guess we already started here, and Maelstrom is about to go down, and it went down. Now we have Hellfire going in. And you might think it's kind of weird that I want this armor because I already have a max Forge Stone and the max Hellfire, which are the same elements in their epics. But there goes my armor, so the Harlequins have to do their work. But I just really like the look of the armor. It's very interesting with very high attack stats, which is one of the main reasons I want it. And there we go, boom, down, didn't even touch the last knight, which is really good. So we're going to go ahead and take this, the PyroDemon Horns, and there we go, level 43 and our 30,000 gold, which I need because I run out of gold really fast. Now you can craft the Aegis of Pyro, and let's open these chests here. Hopefully I'll get something good. I haven't really gotten anything good in a while. And, oh, I can already see right off the bat that we got some gems. Yeah, there we go. Gems, I think it's 15, and then we got a mystic armor, we got metal cogs, we got some phoenix feathers and chimera talons. So yeah, so that's that. And now we are actually going to level up this armor so we can make the plus version. So I will be right back at you when that is over. Oh, hold on, what's up with all my knights? Let me fix that. Was weird. Hellfire back on him. And then this guy, why is he wearing like my non-max Maelstrom? Let's go ahead and put Sandstorm back on him. Alrighty, now I had these two armors that are the same elements, but I want this anyways. So without further ado, I'm going to start enhancing this bad boy, and I will talk to you guys after. And there we go, level 35 on the Aegis of Pyro, regular version. So now that is going to enable us to craft the plus version, like you can see right there on the screen. And yeah, so I guess I'm just gonna go ahead and go over to craft, and I'm gonna craft this bad boy, Aegis of Pyro Plus. Let's go, 2 days and 16 hours. And yeah, so I guess that's all I have to say on the note of the Pyromancer. Another thing is, I'm going to be saving up legendaries to make a fusion video. I'm not going to stop until I have about 25 legendaries, and then I'm going to make a video. This is going to include all the epic bosses from here to a while, everything I get from Guild Wars, everything I get from fusing ultra rares. So yeah, I guess that is all. And one other thing. You might see my 8 fusion boosts. I was not with the bomb squad, my guild, this war because I was earning the trust of a top 10 guild. They don't go top 10 in blitzes like you can see. But yeah, they did really good. Shout out to them. Lords of the Morning. So yeah, next week I'm probably going to go top 10 on the air raid boss. I got that 8 fusion boost, rank 85. So I guess that is all for this video. I'm Magnetic signing off. I will talk to you all later. Goodbye.